This college football season is slowly but surely coming together, as now three of the five Power Five conferences have announced their plans for this upcoming season. The biggest one was, of course, today, guys, as the ACC announced they would be playing an 11-game season with 10 conference games and one non-conference game. And of course, that non-conference game has to be played within their state. So if they had a non-conference game that maybe was at a neutral site or was going to be a true road game, they cannot play that team. And so guys, we're here to break down what the ACC just announced today, what we know from the Big Ten, the Pac-12, the SEC, and the Big 12, and also what to expect from us here at the Gridiron Expert, as of course, we are nearing the end of our prediction season. And most of those predictions, of course, done before these announcements and changes came out. So we're going to talk on the ACC here for just 1 second. Like we said, all the teams will be playing a 10-game conference schedule with one non-conference game. Now the kicker to that is that Notre Dame will be a member of the ACC just for this season. So Notre Dame is coming over, and if you look at their schedule, guys, before all this happened, Notre Dame, I'd say at least half of their schedule was against ACC opponents anyway. So it makes sense for the Fighting Irish to move over, although I think a lot of people are angered and frustrated that Notre Dame is jumping over to this conference and they are eligible to play in the ACC title game and to be crowned ACC champions if they do just that. So I think a lot of people are against that move, but for a program as big as Notre Dame, for a program that competes at such a high level as Notre Dame, it does make sense. I think it is only fair to the Fighting Irish program. So they are a member of the ACC for this year, which means with the 15 teams they have and the way the schedule is laid out, there will not be divisions. You will not have an Atlantic division and a Coastal division. The ACC is going to be structured very much like the Big 12, where it's just all 15 teams and the top two teams by season's end will be meeting in the ACC title game. So that's the way the ACC is looking at playing football this year, guys. And I think that's the best plan we could have hoped for. That's one game less than a full regular season. They're looking to start this season the week of September 12th. So in between September 7th and September 12th, which would have been slated as the beginning of week two. So we're really starting just about on time, and you're getting the majority of the games. I know some teams would have loved to have had those non-conference games, whether they were great resume boosters, whether they would have been great non-conference matchups, whether they would have been easy wins to put on your schedule. I know that can be frustrating and disappointing for some, but again, as we've said ever since this coronavirus pandemic hit months ago, any football and any sports is going to be better than none at all. So that is the ACC's plan, guys, and we are going to continue to monitor that situation as we continue to progress, and of course continue to monitor that as many teams will play different conference opponents than they were originally supposed to in this 2020 season. When you look at the Big Ten and the Pac-12, we do know that those conferences announced weeks ago that they would be canceling all non-conference games. So, of course, we missed out on some big showdowns there. USC, Alabama, Oregon, Ohio State, Iowa State even. Teams like that will not be playing those non-conference games. And the Big Ten and Pac-12 mostly looking at doing a 9-10 game conference-only season. The Pac-12 seems very close, or at least closer, than the Big Ten in terms of making their decision. The Pac-12 saying that they're more than likely going to do a 10-game conference-only slate for this 2020 season. And again, better than nothing, and still keeps your elite teams in the Pac-12, a team like Oregon, maybe a team like USC, in contention for that Pac-12 title and maybe a spot in the college football playoff. And then the SEC, guys, is expected tomorrow to announce their plan for this 2020 season, which is more and more looking like a 10-game conference-only slate, so very similar to the Pac-12. SEC is not confirmed yet. It's just from a lot of sources are saying that that's more than likely going to happen. The commission or the athletic directors within the conference have voted on that. They're meeting one more time again tomorrow on Thursday to see if they want to postpone that decision a little longer or maybe just go ahead and move on with it. But it's looking like the SEC will play a 10-game conference slate. And, of course, we'll still have that SEC championship in December. So there's all of that. And then finally, the Big 12, we don't know yet. They are weighing 4 to 5 different options for the Big 12 this season. Of course, the smallest conference of the Power 5, only hosting 10 members within the Big 12. And they're still kind of formulating how they're going to run this entire season. Because at max, you could have a 9-game conference slate schedule. Of course, 9 conference games, but with no conference wins, it's basically just a normal season for the Big 12 anyways. So a lot of changes here, guys. I think the ACC made a fantastic decision by doing this. I think the ACC handled this better than any other conference has done so far. They've got this decision out there. They're doing it early enough, into July, just like many conferences said they would, and yet they still haven't. So they've got that plan out. Teams can now begin to prep. They've got to restructure the schedules a little bit, but it won't be as difficult as maybe canceling all non-conference games while still trying to play an 11-12 game season. So I really credit the ACC to what they're doing here. I really credit all the programs for getting on board with this. And I really hope that this pans out, guys. Of course, we'll only know as time goes on, as this virus continues to rage, and we'll really see how much football we're able to play this season. A few weeks into this season, depending on how well the players respond and if any of them contract the virus. So that is what we're looking at, guys. The ACC has made their decision. Big Ten and Pac-12 right behind them. SEC could be tomorrow, should be as early as next week if they decide to postpone. Now, what does that mean for us here at the Gridiron Expert? We've already received a handful of comments. We know that the schedules are going to be restructured, guys. We know that we've already predicted the SEC, the Big Ten. We're in the middle of the Big 12 right now. We predicted all the ACC and all the independents. So we're aware of that, and we're going to come out with updated predictions in the following weeks. Once we know we have a game plan for every conference, once we see the updated schedules for every team, we'll go through, we'll re-predict all those teams. We're not going to have individual videos. We're not going to have individual game-by-game prediction videos for each team because we simply don't have time for that. By the time all these announcements are made, we'll be less than a month out from the start of the season, and we won't be able to get through all 60, 70 plus Power 5 programs. But we will come out with updated conference recaps just like we do for every Power 5 conference. We'll do the same for every Group of 5 conference. So you're still going to get our analysis. We'll tell you the updated records. We'll tell you who we now have them beating instead of losing to, vice versa. Trust me, we've got you covered. We're not going to leave you empty-handed on these predictions going into 2020. So those will come in the following weeks as we finally get more of a grasp about the whole situation. As we continue to hear what the other conferences decide to do, we will come out with those updated predictions for every single team. But we will, in the meantime, continue to post the predictions that we already have completed. We've already completed all of our Big 12 videos. We're still sending those out every day. We've already filmed ahead and completed all of the Pac-12. Those will come out right after the Big 12. Those videos will still come out, and those are still meaningful because we're predicting conference games in those videos, guys. So if we have, let's say, Oregon taking down Washington and USC, for example. Not saying we do, but let's just say. Then we're not going to change that when the Pac-12 restructures their schedule and when they decide to make their official decision. So conference games in our predictions in the following days and weeks still matter, and that's why we will continue to release these pre-shot prediction videos. And then again, we'll come out with updated records and conference champions once we have a firm game plan from all the respective conferences. So guys, we are heading in the right direction. We are heading in the right direction, and a college football season seems more and more possible right now. I know there's still a lot of doubt out there, but the fact that one Power 5 conference already has a game plan in place, the fact that a few others are very close to it, makes me believe that in a few weeks, in about a month's time, we will have college football. The only question is, how long will it last? Something that we will continue to monitor, but don't worry, regardless, we will have constant updates and constant analysis right here at the Gridiron Expert. Year-round college football analysis, predictions, and news all the time, 24/7, 365. So guys, thank you so much for watching this brief update on what to expect in the following weeks from the Power 5 conferences within all of college football. Make sure to continue to like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for more prediction videos. We've got Texas coming out later tonight, and then we continue through our final two conferences over the following weeks. So thank you guys so much. And we'll see you guys next right here on the Gridiron Expert.